We've got some more exciting news about the upcoming EA Sports College Football 25 game that is dropping this summer. Now, a few days ago, EA Sports did drop a teaser trailer, and we're gonna go back and look at some of the little tidbits and things that they snuck into that trailer and kind of break them down. But we also got some even more exciting news that has been hitting Twitter over the past couple days that we're gonna talk about a little bit later in the video. Now, if you never wanna miss out on any of the news or updates surrounding this game, especially a lot of the big news we're gonna start getting very soon and the first gameplay videos, make sure to subscribe and turn the bell icon on so you never miss any of these important updates when they go live. I'm trying to hit 600k subscribers before the game comes out, so if everybody watching just subscribed, we could hit that number in literally a few days. Now, when this trailer dropped a few days ago, a lot of people were pointing out some little tidbits that they actually snuck in there, and while we did talk about the trailer a few days ago, I do want to kind of go over some of the little things in the trailer before we get to some of the other big news. Now, the opening scene shows the Rose Bowl, and I saw some people asking, is this an actual render of the stadium in-game? Now, me personally, I don't think this is in-game footage. I think this is just the actual stadium because they shot the teaser and the entire commercial here at the stadium, but graphics are so good nowadays that you could kind of make the argument that it could maybe be an actual render of the stadium. We know in game it's not going to look too much worse than this, if at all, but I don't think this is an actual clip from the game. This is the actual stadium, in my opinion. Now, another interesting thing I saw a lot of people bring up is that the guy in the video is working on the jersey. He's sewing the number 25 on the jersey for EA Sports College Football 25. And he mentions in the video about how the game has kind of taken a little bit and people have been waiting for it. And he says that this is not the only jersey that they've been working on.
Just say, this ain't the only jersey we've been working on.
Now, shortly after he says that, they actually show some of the jerseys in-game, some of the real jerseys that they were scanning, and then some of the rendered jerseys in-game, which look really good. But a lot of people thought when he said that this isn't the only jersey they've been working on, that maybe they're actually working on a college basketball game as well. Now, as far as I know, and as far as Matt Brown knows, who has been one of the most reliable sources about this game, there is currently no college basketball game in the works. But it is interesting to note that when NBA Live was canceled a few years back, they said that they'd be working on something for the next generation. So you never know. Now that NIL is in place and things are kind of rolling with this game, maybe they are going to start looking into a college basketball game. I don't personally think they would do that because I don't think there's enough sales in that game. As it stands, college sports are very niche and college basketball is even more niche than football. As it stands, Madden always far outsold college football. And I know a lot of people think with this game coming back, it's going to outsell Madden. But the projections from both people at EA and people that work in the industry are just hoping this game sells like 30 to 40% of what Madden does. Now, maybe it'll sell a little better than that because it has been gone for so long. But make no mistake about it, college sports are a lot more niche than the major leagues. NFL and NBA is always going to far exceed anything that the college sports do. And even back in the day when they had these college games, Madden far and away outsold college football. And that's probably going to remain the same. And that is what most experts in the industry anticipate happening. And they just hope that the sales are decent and they have a good amount of hype so that it kind of warrants them putting all this time and money into the game. And so with that said, I just don't think there's enough money out there for a college basketball game. I mean, they stopped making college basketball games long before they actually had to stop making college games. They stopped making that in like 2010. So it just kind of goes to show you that the market really wasn't there for it. Now, as far as the jerseys in game, they look really good. We could see them scanning the Nebraska jersey, and then we see a render of it that's not completely done in game yet. And then we start moving on to some other jerseys that they showed, like the Michigan jersey, the champions here. And you could just see the detail on these jerseys. Looks almost a little bit better than what they currently look like in Madden, but I don't think they're going to be too different, to be honest. This is just a year later, so it should look slightly better. But you could see, I mean, even the threading on some of these jerseys, when you're looking at the Florida State jersey, for example, which looks just absolutely amazing. You can literally see the stitching on the jersey, on the Nike check, on the ACC patch. And if this is what it's going to look like in game, we're going to have a beautiful looking game. And it should, because it's 2024 and they've worked on it for so many years. We can see the Texas A&M jersey render with the helmet as well, which is looking pretty solid. Not as much of an up close look here. Also got the Florida Gators as well with the helmet looking really good. I mean, like I said, I think that, you know, I wish they would have showed a little bit more, but it is only February. We know the full reveal's coming in May, but for what we got to see so far, we definitely can see that, you know, some of the details are there, and it's still very early on. They also showed a close-up of the Georgia helmet, which, I mean, looks so good to the point where you can even see and read the warning label. So we know we're going to get a graphically good game, but we know Madden is always graphically, you know, really nice looking as well. We're really more worried about how the gameplay and how the modes play more than anything, but it's good to see, you know, little bits and pieces. Now, we're going to to continue on with some of the bigger news in this video, but really quickly, I want to shout out today's video sponsor, Underdog Fantasy. They're my favorite fantasy app, but what I really love about Underdog Fantasy is their pick'em game. What you do is pick higher or lower on a wide variety of player stats, and if they hit, you can win some big money. And the best part about Underdog Fantasy is that sign up, they're going to always give you a free play to help you win some money right out of the gate. So with it being All-Star Weekend, for example, they're going to give you LeBron James to score a single point. All he has to do is score 1 point, and that's it. You win. And during the NBA season, there's always going to be plays like this every week. For example, on Thursday, they're going to give you Steph Curry to get a single point. Next weekend, they're going to give you Jason Tatum, so on and so forth. Whenever you sign up, there will always be a free play like this for you to take advantage of. And if you sign up using my promo code Ray, R-A-Y, they're going to also double your first deposit up to $100. So if you deposit $100, they're going to give you a free $100 on top of that to play with, and you just can't beat that. Now, another thing that they showed in this trailer that I thought was interesting was they showed some in-development shots of some of the stuff we can expect in the game. So you can see the Penn State mascot running out. So this is clearly going to be a running out animation at the beginning of the game. Obviously, this is a very, very early in-development shot. I'm sure the game is much further along than this, but they're not going to show that right now because they're going to wait till we get closer to release. But you can see just a little bit of the animation quality and kind of what you can expect there. You see the Oklahoma, the fire at the beginning of the game there where they're probably going to be running out. You can see the Tennessee stadium as well. Again, this is just a render of the stadium. Obviously, it's going to look way better than this in game, but they're just kind of showing the progress of kind of building up and developing the game. They're also showing the Florida Gatorhead, which is something, you know, we've seen in the old NCAA games when they would show this in the pregame. And another thing they focused on in this video was they showed some renders of the mascots. Of course, we've got the Alabama mascot and the Michigan State mascot, but just looking at the Alabama mascot itself, I mean, again, graphically, this game is going to look amazing, and it's going to look even better just because the last game we have to compare it to was NCAA 14. So it's going to be one of those big jumps that we don't typically get to see graphically with games anymore, because even when we go from one generation to another, you know, with a Madden or NBA 2K, the graphics don't change nearly as much nowadays as they used to back in like the PS2 days. But since this game has not been out for 10 years, we're going to actually see such a huge graphic jump from what we're used to seeing that it's going to kind of look even better in a way because of that. But even throughout this teaser, they showed real life mascots sprinkled in here a lot, which I think is alluding to the fact that they are bringing back the mascot mode, which is something that's been heavily asked about. Of course, we know Dynasty, Road to Glory, Ultimate Team, things like that are going to be in the game, but a lot of people have wondered, are they bringing back mascot modes? And with how much they've focused on mascots just in this little teaser, I think the answer would be yes, and that's why they're showing them so much. Another big thing people have been pointing to in the trailer is at the very end, after they said that it was coming this summer and that the full reveal would be in May, they snuck this final clip in here of the clapboard, and it has some interesting data on it. So the first thing people were pointing out was the 6-7 at the top. Now, me personally, I don't know that this means something, but I also don't think they would have just snuck this in here at the end for no reason. I don't think the numbers on the screen completely mean nothing, because otherwise there's just no reason for them to put that in there. They know what people are going to speculate. So the 6-7 can mean one or two things. That can mean June 7th or that can mean July 6th. Now, as far as everybody knows, this game is set to drop in July, and that is always when the college football games drop before. I don't know if they've ever dropped in June ever. They almost always, to my knowledge, dropped in July. But here's the thing. July 6th is a Saturday. Now, the rumored release date that has not been confirmed is July 12th, which is a Friday, and all media releases on Fridays. But sometimes they do early releases for like deluxe editions or things like that, or they do the EA Play early release where you get an early trial. Now, if that's the case, maybe they're releasing it about a week early on a Saturday, which would make sense because Saturday is the day of college football during the week. So we could maybe be seeing an early release on July 6th with the official release being July 12th. Again, this is speculation. This is not confirmed. Now, another interesting thing here is if this date is June 7th, well, that actually is a Friday. So that could make sense as well. But even if they were going to release this game in June, which is completely against what they've done in the past, June 7th is very early. Like, if anything, it would be late June. It wouldn't be early. So I just can't see that being the release date. And another thing people have been speculating is on the second line here, you have 18-5. And then right next to that, you actually have 24. And some people are speculating that that means May 18th, 24 is when we're getting the full reveal, which could absolutely be true. I think there is a good possibility that is true because we know that's coming in May. So they threw these little tidbits in here. It says, tell your friends. I don't think these numbers mean nothing, but everybody's going to speculate until these things actually happen. Now, another big thing that's been really really happening over the past couple of days is a lot of the schools that are going to be in the game have been kind of promoting it on Twitter, you know, further solidifying that this game is actually coming out. Because yes, believe it or not, there are still a few weirdos out there that somehow think the game still isn't real even after EA dropped a damn teaser trailer. I don't think there's any hope left for those guys personally, but a lot of these schools are posting on Twitter, you know, custom covers of their players on the cover of EA Sports College Football saying that they're in the game. Now, of course, we know all of the FBS schools are in the game. That's already been confirmed. So all of your major institutions are going to be in the game. But we've seen a lot of these programs like Colorado posting, you know, their custom covers saying that they're going to be in the game. We've seen Texas A&M do it. We've seen Marshall do it. We've seen BYU posting that they're in the game. We've seen Ole Miss post that they're in the game. And clearly, again, we know that these schools are in there because we know all of the major FBS schools are going to be in the game. But here is the interesting thing that we have been seeing today is that we're actually seeing FCS schools confirm that they're going to be in the game. Now, we don't know how many, but we've seen quite a few FCS schools post that they're in the game. We've seen Gardner-Webb University post their custom cover saying that they're in the game. We've seen Portland State University post a custom cover and they said, who's ready to build a Portland State dynasty? We've seen Eastern Washington post about this as well. So all of these FCS schools are reporting that they're in the game and they're also promoting it along with the FBS teams, which is interesting because a few months ago, it was rumored that the FCS teams would not be in the game at launch, but rather they would come at a later point. Now that might still be true. They may not be in the game at launch, but the fact that they are posting about this means that they are definitely going to be in this year's game at some point, even if that's through maybe an update a month or two after release. But what I think is happening here is I think some of these FCS teams actually might be in the game at launch. Otherwise, I don't think they would currently be posting about it. Now, are they going to have every single FCS team in at launch? I highly doubt that. I think that's almost 100% certain that that will not happen, but it appears that we're actually going to get some FCS teams in at launch or at worst during an update for EA Sports College Football 25 this year, which is pretty huge news because I think a lot of people were assuming we might have to wait till like next year's game to get those teams in. But the fact that we're going to be getting some of those this year, and who knows exactly how much, it might be a lot, it might just be a few of them, but the fact that some of them are going to be in the game is actually very huge because a lot of people really want to see that. Now, if you want to know all of the rumors and leaks that we have heard about this game over the past year and everything that's pretty much been confirmed to be in it, make sure to check out this video right here on the screen.